He's gonna land. Get all the stuff out of the way, quick, go!
Land? Yeah, land.
All right, hold on. He's gonna land. Some high flying action with Resident Evil back in theaters. So the question is, should you see it, rent it, or skip it? Our movie critic from fatguysatthemovies.com, Kevin Carr, joining us with the answer this morning. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Okay, so Afterlife, it's the fourth in the Resident Evil series.
Fourth?
Is it getting old yet?
It was getting old like at episode two.
After the first one.
Yeah, I mean, they're fun to watch. It's just explosions and actions, but yeah, there's not a whole lot of story here. It's not rich in story.
Yeah.
I mean, this is not Hamlet on the screen with zombies or anything like that. So yeah, it is getting a little old. You know, it's for the fans of the series, I guess.
Right, and also it's based on the video game.
Mm-hmm. Capcom's video game series. And
taking
it's...
taking on zombies.
Yeah.
So that's basically what happens.
Well, yeah, it's if you look here, it's really just an excuse to shoot things.
Yeah.
And that's what a lot of these video games are. It's just a chance to, you know, just have situations where zombies are coming at you and shoot at them and then kill them all. And that's, they built a whole series, four movies around that. So it does tend to just be an excuse for action and explosions and gunplay and everything.
But I imagine if you did play the video games, that this would probably be something you would enjoy. You didn't play the video games.
I don't have the time to play the video games. But I've heard that people have liked these movies in their adaptation of it. So again, it's just a big action kind of reasons for action, reason for explosions.
What about the cast? I know Allie Larder's in it. How
yeah, Allie Larder from Heroes, and Mila Jovovich, who has been in the other movies as well, Married to the Director, and all that kind of thing. They're good. I mean, it's you know, women kicking butt, and you know what's wrong with that? I enjoy watching.
Nothing's
that.
Wrong with that. And it's also in 3D, right? It's shot in 3D.
Yeah, shot in 3D with the same sort of camera systems they did Avatar in, and it looks really good. I mean, it has some really neat 3D effects. I saw it in the IMAX last night.
Okay.
So, you know, but the 3D's good, the action's good, and it stops about there. It gets really stupid in the first 5 minutes and doesn't quite recover.
Well, there's no plot, you know, essentially.
I guess, not really.
Yeah.
Yeah, we gotta blow things up. We're shooting zombies.
So you're saying see it, rent it, or skip it. I'm gonna guess.
Yeah.
You're saying skip it?
I'm saying skip it. I mean, unless you really want to see the 3D, because you're not going to see it at home unless you buy one of those really expensive TVs.
Right.
But so that's kind of like the only reason to see it, but it's not worth $15.
Okay. Well, since there is limited new releases, that's really the only one this weekend in theaters, it's really a good time to catch up on the summer movies that maybe you haven't seen yet.
Yeah.
So what are you recommending to folks? What's your favorite, I guess, so far this summer?
Favorite of the summer was Toy Story 3.
Okay.
You know, it's already made over $400 million domestically and $1 billion worldwide. Great movie, great ending to the series.
Okay, and you also liked Despicable Me, didn't you?
Yeah, another animated film that was a lot of fun with, you know, Steve Carell playing the bad guy in this one. Or the good guy.
What about Salt?
This one was a surprising one. I really thought it was a neat little action movie with Angelina Jolie.
Yeah.
She thinks she's a Russian spy. Neat little movie, I will say.
Neat little movie.
Neat little
so
movie.
You recommend folks see that if they haven't.
Check it out if you haven't.
Okay, and we have to talk about Inception, because that was my favorite of the summer. Yes.
Good.
Leonardo?
Well, yeah.
Amazing.
He was good. He does a good job. So.
Did you see it more than once?
No, I just saw it once.
Okay.
I got it.
I've seen
a lot of movies. I see so many sci-fi, but I know a lot of people struggle with the...
lot of people were saying, I've got to go back and see that again.
Yeah, so. They argue about the ending. I don't get into the arguing. No, just see the movie and enjoy it.
See the movie
and
enjoy it. All right, so if you're not into football this weekend, because believe it or not, there are a few people out there that are not going to be watching the Bucks game. It may be raining, so it's a good weekend and maybe to take in a movie.
Yeah.
Saturday night's your best bet for that. So Kevin Carr, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
And Lisa, you're keeping an eye.